In April, Microsoft added two new features to the roadmap for Access: modern chart improvements and Monaco as the new SQL editor. The rollout is planned for August and September. The Access team presented the current development status at the Access DevCon Vienna. Earlier this week, I published a video about the Monaco editor in this channel. Let's move on to the second topic. The modern charts were introduced 6 years ago, and now they are to be brought up to the level of the charts in other Office applications, such as PowerPoint and Excel. Tusha Shine and Courtney Owen from the Access team show us what they are working on.
My name is Tushar Jain. I and Courtney have been working on modern chart improvements. The whole goal of this feature is to bring new visualization and charting capabilities to MS Access, at the same time making them more customizable and user-friendly. In the current charting experience, as we can see on the right, there were frequent customer requests that we kept receiving. One was that the number of charts that MS Access was currently offering was lower as compared to what was being offered in similar products and like partner products such as PowerPoint and Excel and Word. Users wanted new kinds of different kinds of visualization and charting options. At the same time, the design experience was very limited, where you could just create a chart and the amount of things you could customize within that chart in terms of design and at the same time what kind of data you could put in was pretty limited. So we wanted to increase the capabilities and make it much more comprehensive so that the experience was at par with other partner products. And at the same time, we wanted to increase overall customizability, where we would enable different kinds of features that could actually help with it, such as interactivity, where you could hover over and interact with specific and target elements within the chart. And you weren't limited to just having a static chart rendered once you entered the data in it. First of all, since our last presentation at AEK and the MVP Summit, we have introduced many more charting options than we had initially planned. Initially, it was just the first four options, which was Scatter, Donut, Radar, and Box and Whisker. We came to this conclusion based on how much these charts are used across other Microsoft Office products. But as we realized that since we had moved our code structure to a much more plug-and-play mechanism where we could introduce more chart types, we tested along with other chart types that we could introduce and bring it to you guys, and hence we have many more options available for you now. Along with the first four, we are also planning on introducing area charts, funnel charts, bubble charts, and word cloud. We are also planning to upgrade the data panes. Currently, the way the experience is, the data pane remains the same no matter what the chart type is. So the idea behind this particular feature is that we want to upgrade the data pane so that it can be more modular in nature to support for all the new different kinds of chart types that we are planning on introducing. We are also going to provide many more different kinds of interactivity options where you can interact with the chart. A few things that get enabled would be new font orientations, hovering over a particular chart to get dynamic grid lines and dynamic tooltips, which could actually mention more informational data. At the same time, we would be able to granularly customize the chart elements. So say there is a bar chart, we could actually assign the different bars different colors, or like a pie chart, each slice of the pie could actually be given a different color and those sorts of things. There were a few recommendations that we received during the previous sessions, and we are planning on integrating those kinds of suggestions such as percentages within the system as well. Overall, it is going to make the whole modern charting feature, which already exists in Access, much more customizable, interactive, and modern in nature, bringing it at par with all the partner products of Microsoft Office. How are we implementing this, and why wasn't it previously implemented? So the way the code was structured within Access previously, we were targeting certain core chart types, and that is where we were like keeping our focus. This time when we are moving forward, where we are upgrading on the previous versions is that we are making the code, much more modular in nature, bringing sort of a plug and play experience within the code, where every time a new chart is introduced within our framework, which is the IV charts framework that we will be using, we shall be able to introduce it. So what we will see as a result is that every time a new chart comes into the market and is very much in demand, Axis shall be able to introduce those kinds of chart types fairly fast and easily as compared to the way it was previously moving. We were also able to like bring additional capabilities because of using this framework. Yeah, overall, these are the improvements that we brought forward through the implementation. And I would like to just hand it over to Courtney for a short demo of the various chart types that we are planning on introducing.
Okay, so this is all on my dev machine right now. If we go into Insert Modern Chart here, you'll now see the drop down here. And we can certainly organize this differently, but we have the new area charts. You're noticing there's no icon yet because Tushar just checked in the icons a couple days ago and they haven't yet made it into our branch. So for now, they're just showing without icons, but they'll all still work. So you see area, we have area, stacked area, 100% stacked area, radar, we have radar and radar filled. We have box whisker, which I'll be honest with you guys, before I started this, I didn't know what box whisker was. And I actually watched an 8-minute instructional video the other day explaining how to read data in box whisker charts. So I will just say that implementing this one was the toughest of all of them. Finally nailed it down late last week. Bubble charts. Donut chart, the reason we have an icon here is, but that icon already existed in our code and I was just able to pull it in. Funnel chart, scatter chart, this is the one that Tushar has already checked in. And word cloud, and this is the one that's TBD. I don't know if you guys are interested in this, I'll demo it. Excel doesn't offer this. It's kind of cool. I don't know if you guys will think it's that cool, but if you do think it's worthwhile, we can include it. So we'll just go ahead and first insert an area chart. Okay, so this is an area chart. One thing I want to call out, you guys may have noticed over the last few years that sample data did not populate the charts when you inserted them in. They were just sort of empty. We figured out this bug last week and it's been there for a few years. So you'll notice that now the charts actually get pre-populated with sample data. So if I go here, I can shift over to area stacked. That's the new chart type, area stacked, and area stacked 100%. So these were super easy to implement, these ones. Now let's select some other chart types. Our sample data that we have is pretty static. So the radar chart, for example, we may want to use a different sample data set. So what I'm going to do here is I have some more interesting data that I'm going to use here that will more give you a better demonstration of how a radar chart would look. I don't know if that's something you guys have been yearning to have, but it's apparently quite a popular option in Excel. And then we similarly have radar filled. If we compare our chart with the exact same data against Excel, we're showing exactly the same thing they are. So the next one that I mentioned that was a real chore to implement was box and whisker. As I said, I can tell you, if you aren't familiar with box and whisker, I can send you a little video on how to read these types of charts. But these are called whiskers. These lines have to do with the lowest and highest point in the data. And then these boxes are medians for the data set. So once again, if we compare the exact same data set against Excel for box and whisker, we look exactly the same. Bubble chart. Now I'm gonna shift to a more interesting data set here for bubble chart. And this is just car makes and units sold. And this just shows, you know, how much a particular car maker sold units for a month. So that's the bubble chart type. We can shift this. Let's shift it to the funnel type. And this is the funnel type. Now, Tushar mentioned that we want to have the data panes make sense for the particular chart type. So we give sort of the options in the data pane that make sense for the particular chart type here. We can similarly use, let's see the next chart type we have here, scatter. This is scatter chart type. And the last one I'll show you with this particular data set is word cloud. The word will be larger based upon the size of the sum units sold for each car maker. So I don't know if that's something you guys are interested in. You can chime in if that's something you would ever feel is useful. If not, we'll just pull it out. But it was easy to implement. So then the last one I want to show you is Donut. And I want to find a different data set for this. And what Donut does is it allows you to have a ring of a ring for each series. And you can turn on the data labels for each of these. As far as the formatting goes, we're still filling in the particular formatting options that we want to have for each chart type. Some of them I've populated already, but those are the chart types that we have on tap for now. I don't think I missed anything. All the old chart types, of course, will continue to work. So that's about all I have.
You have the opportunity to express your opinions to the Access team in the comments to the video. May the work succeed.